Hello, and welcome to this video about converting decimals, improper fractions, and mixed numbers. In this video, we will explore the steps to convert a decimal to a fraction and a mixed number to an improper fraction, and vice versa. We use fractions and decimals daily. All our money transactions are done in decimal form. When we bake, we use half cups and 1/3 cups. Being able to convert between a decimal and a fraction is a math skill you will use every single day. The table shows a decimal, an improper fraction, and a mixed number that are all equivalent. When converting a decimal to a fraction, we start by multiplying the decimal by a fraction that is equivalent to 1. So the value of the decimal does not change. For example, there's only one number after the decimal, in other words, the number in the tenths place. The number would be multiplied by 10 over 10. If there are two numbers after the decimal, the last digit is in the hundredths place, we would multiply the number by 100 over 100, and so on. After multiplying, we simplify the fraction. Let's take a look at an example. We will convert 5.85 into fraction form. Since there are two numbers after the decimal, we will multiply 5.85 by 100 over 100. 5.85 times 100 over 100 is equal to 585 over 100. To simplify the fraction, we will start by breaking down the number into its factors. Then we will cancel out the common factors in the numerator and denominator. Both numbers have a factor of 5, so 585 over 100 can be simplified to 117 over 20. The fraction equivalent to 5.85 is 117 over 20, which is also called an improper fraction. We will now convert the improper fraction into a mixed number. We will convert the improper fraction 117 over 20 to a mixed number by first dividing the numerator by the denominator. The whole number becomes the number in front of the fraction, the remainder becomes the numerator of the fraction, and the denominator of the fraction remains the same. Therefore, 117 over 20 converted to a mixed number is 5 17/20. Here's an example of how we use conversions in real life. Sam owns a bakery. She has 5 3/4 kilograms of sugar. She buys another bag with 10.75 kilograms of sugar. What is the total amount of sugar in kilograms that Sam has for baking? Give your answer in fraction form. First, we will start by converting 10.75 to fraction form by multiplying it by 100 over 100, which is 1,075 over 100. Once the fraction is simplified, we get 43 over 4, which when converted to a mixed number is 10 3/4. Now that both numbers are in mixed number form, we can easily combine to find the total amount of sugar that Sam has for her baking. So all we're going to do is add 5 3/4 plus 10 3/4. When we add mixed numbers, we want to start by adding the fractional parts. So let's do 3/4 plus 3/4. That gives us 6/4 because we add our numerators and our denominator stays the same. Now if you notice, we have an improper fraction. So let's convert that to a mixed number. If we divide the numerator by the denominator, we'll get 1 2/4, which can be simplified to 1 1/2. Now we're gonna add this part to our whole number parts from earlier. So 5 plus 10 is 15, plus 1 1/2 is equal to 16 1/2. So Sam has 16 1/2 kilograms of sugar for baking. I hope this video on converting decimals, improper fractions, and mixed numbers was helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying.